Mr. Placencia. I am the principal of the dual immersion program and also your principal for Currie Middle School. And I'm here to introduce the dual immersion teachers. So if I could have our students please quiet it down so you could hear your all-star team as I mentioned their name. Voy a anunciar las maestras del doble inmersión. Yo soy el señor Placencia, el director de la escuela Currie, de la escuela secundaria, y también el director de la escuela del doble inmersión. Y voy a introducir los maestros del doble inmersión. Por favor, dales un aplauso. Primero voy a empezar con la maestra Picasso de Kindergarten. La maestra Guevara. La maestra Ramírez. Son del equipo de Kinder de doble inmersión. De primer grado, la maestra Armijo. La maestra Quevedo.
La maestra that's your teacher.
Este es su equipo de primer grado. This is our first grade dual immersion team. Let's give them a round of applause. Second grade team, el equipo de segundo grado de doble inmersión, la maestra Rodríguez, la maestra Handley, y la maestra Noriega es del tercer grado. El maestro de 3-4 es la maestra Laviosa. Un aplauso, muchachos, por favor.
Session, but welcome to first grade. My name is Pam Quevedo, and I will be your son, your daughter's first grade teacher this year, and I am thrilled to be here at Thorman. I know some of you were a little wary at the end of the school year at day, what's it gonna be like? Thorman might have a little reputation, but I can guarantee you that the dual teachers are gonna make this such a positive experience for you, and it will begin right here in room 20. So this is my class picture from last year. So a little about me, I was born in Costa Rica in 1986, so I'm not shy to tell you my age, I'm 32. This is my sixth year of teaching. I taught 4 years in middle school, sixth and seventh grade Spanish. Last year was my first year teaching dual, and this will be my second. Last year I was in a K-1 combo, and this year it's strictly first, and I couldn't be more excited to really just dive into the first grade curriculum 100%. Although last year I felt like I did it, but with Kinder, it was a little bit more difficult. So I got my bachelor's in 2008 from UCI in psychology and social behavior. I also have my master's in education from Pepperdine. I have 3 credentials, and I'm currently getting my administrative credential in case in the future I want to become principal. You never know, you never know. You gotta keep my options open. So the dual immersion program now in first grade, it's an 80-20. That means I will strictly be speaking to your child in Spanish. Your child cannot know that I speak English, so any communication that you have with me outside of school needs to be either you're miming or writing it down, because I cannot break code for the integrity of the dual program. 20% will be taught in English, and I will get to that in a little bit. Questions so far? I'm notorious for talking fast, but I promise I speak very slow in Spanish. Okay, so class starts at 8 a.m. I will be picking up the kids at 7:55 because I do want them in class working on their desk assignment by 8:03. The line will be line number 20, and it's like right outside this door. They can't miss it. 9:55 to 10 a.m. We have recess, snack. Definitely, I recommend, because it is hot, to send your son or daughter a water bottle because they are going to get thirsty. We are very fortunate to have facilities in the class that provide water, but they always like to have their own. And a snack, so they are not jittery throughout the day. And we have lunch from 11:25 to 12:10, so a good 45 minutes. So please pack them a good and healthy lunch. At Vay, they said none of the Flamin' Hot Cheetos or anything flaming. So let's try to keep that here. Even though we haven't been told, everything's been happening like boom, boom, boom so fast. So let's just keep the principal happy, right? 2:23 is dismissal. On the little quarter sheet that I gave you, if you could tell me how your child will be picked up tomorrow on the first day of school, that would be so helpful. And we have 109 minimum day on Wednesday. So it's pretty much the same as Vay. English library and PE times will be announced as soon as possible. We still do not know that. And please, and I already said this. I just want there to be a lot of time for questioning. Okay, so the school uniform, it's very similar to Vay, except here they're a little bit more strict about it. And I know they're going to be a stickler about picking out students that are not in uniform. So just giving you a heads up so your child does not get picked out. So the top polo or t-shirt, white, blue, or red, and no logos whatsoever. Bottoms, denim, khaki, or navy blue, and shoes, please, closed toe. They play rough sometimes at recess, and I don't want any stubbed toes. I know the sandals are cute, and the flats, but still, anything with laces is always ideal. Yes?
Quick question. Prima already went out and bought the little kind of navyish blue, but they're kind of like full dress.
Oh yeah, the dresses are totally fine. Okay. Yeah, absolutely. Just make sure we wear like some shorts underneath, because I know kindergartners like to woo, let it all out. Okay, so the math curriculum, I won't go in depth. Something that I'm really going to be good at this year is sending home a weekly or monthly newsletter. I'm still deciding what I want to do. Explaining what will be covered in math, using our math expressions book, Maravillas for Language Arts. You're in kindergarten, it was mostly learning sílabas and abecedario, correct? So this year we are still learning to read, so that way in second grade there are reading to learn. So first grade, learning to read. And Fountains and Pinnell for English, Maestra Zamora will be teaching the English curriculum. So she will be, I'll be going to Ms. Armijo's class, Ms. Zamora here, and that way she can break code with them. And STEM scopes for science. So I will be more detailed about it. I'm usually really good at communication. If you think I talk a lot in person, imagine an email. It's nonstop. Okay, homework. Homework will not start, I'm guessing, until 2 weeks. There is a Thorman folder that is going to go home every Thursday with announcements inside, okay? And anything that your child completes in class will be put in here. If you look in the back, those that salmon, it says los buzones, those little cubbies, that's all their work that they do for the week, they'll put in here. So they'll take this home on Thursday. It needs to be brought back on Friday. And then I have my own individual homework folder that will have the assignments, the homework sheet on Monday, and this will be returned on Friday. So two folders, and I will have two bins on Friday that your kids can just drop it in. So far, so good. Homework, do not even worry, it's way too early. And first grade homework consists of 15 minutes of reading, English or Spanish, it does not matter. I will provide Spanish resources as the year goes on. I know in kinder we use RAS kits, correct? That will continue once we get our passcodes and usernames and all that stuff. And math pages from homework. If your child cannot do the homework on their own, just write me a note. They should not be staying up late doing homework. They are in first grade, and we want them to love learning. That is my goal. So if you feel like they're gonna have a breakdown, just stop. I really do not mind. Okay, so my class expectations are just respect the classroom, be safe, be kind to others, and ready to learn. I will be going over with your child what this looks like in the different parts of school. Like, the what does this look like in the playground, in the bathroom, in the lunch tables, in the classroom. So just a lot of repetition. It's better to keep them short and sweet for them to really embrace them. Okay? Rewards and consequences. Thorman has these Thorman alert cards. They called them pride cards and they got to go to a pride store. But here they have amazing rewards when your child does receive an alert card. They have to get so many to receive a prize. And when you get this tomorrow, even though tomorrow's not Thursday and I said it's your Thursday folder, I still wanted to go home, it will have what the prizes are for the Thorman cards. It's pretty spectacular. I'm like, wow. It's like, they was a little behind with the prizes. Once I saw them, I'm like, ay, 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 you know? So they'll be doing that individually. I'll give like a high five or a smile or a positive cactus note, because cactus is my thing. Have you noticed? So I'll usually like walk by and I'll just, you know, I won't give them out like hotcakes or anything because it'll lose the meaning. But every once in a while, I will, you know, reward someone and write a personal note so you can see what they got it for. So, and it makes it feel good. Put a nice little sticker on there. Kids love that stuff. Right? And warnings. So we review the zones of regulation. We always want them to be at a green, where they are nice and calm, ready to learn, you know, in tune with what they are doing. So we don't want them to ever get to red, where they are so angry they just cannot concentrate. So I will show them techniques and how we can get them back to green. So we will go over this the first couple weeks of school, and they're called the zones of regulation. So the first one will be just a warning. I mean, they're kids. They don't need to be like boom, boom, boom. You know, we got to take it easy. They each have a number, and here's my heart. So sometimes I'll just say, just move your number. That's it. So they just come up here. I hope I didn't put it too high for them. But and they'll just be out, so that way I know, okay, I need that kid might lose a privilege or something. They can always come back and live inside my heart, always. So it's not like they're out and it's like broken, no, it just comes in. A quick little thing, just move your number. I like to do it quick and fast to not interrupt the whole class learning. And then if the number was just not enough, they'll lose a privilege and I will call home. Okay, you can contact me. I put it in the yellow sheet. pquevedo@tusden.k12.ca.us. The P stands for Pam or Pamela. And then if you look underneath your child's name tag, I put a C. Make sure it is your kid's seesaw. So look at the highlighted. It gives you instructions. You have to download the free app on your iPhone. You can also do it on your computer. I did Remind app last year, so it'll be my first year doing all the seesaw, but I'm ready, you know? I'm ready for change. So if this will be my way of communicating with you through email or seesaw. Please do this as soon as you can. Take this home with you.